Hello and welcome back to your own channel Indian Defense Analysis, where we bring to you all the latest development happening in the defense sector.
The People's Liberation Army Navy plan has a massive submarine fleet in the world. It operates a fleet of 66 submarines, which includes nuclear as well as conventional submarines. At the same time, Indian Navy operates a fleet of 17 submarines. It's quite evident Indian Navy cannot match up these numbers in just a couple of decades, and it does not need to. China has a massive maritime claim and dispute over South China Sea with almost every country sharing the coast. This is the reason why it has to build a massive fleet to support its aggressive policy. At the same time, Indian Navy has adopted a smarter strategy and acquired a lot of important anti-submarine assets to checkmate China, which are of world class. For example, fleet of P-8I maritime reconnaissance aircrafts, Romeo MH-60R helicopters, and indigenously developed dedicated anti-submarine warfare shallow water craft, which is nightmare for Chinese submarines. Considering the importance of anti-submarine warfare, Indian Navy has ordered for 16 ASW-SWC corvettes, or the anti-submarine warfare vessels, from Cochin Shipyard Limited (CSL) and Garden Reach Shipbuilders and Engineers (GRSE). In December 2013, the Ministry of Defence has approved the purchase of 16 shallow water anti-submarine vessels at a cost of Rs 13,440 crores. These vessels will replace the Avay class corvette currently in service, which has entered into the service with Indian Navy in 1989. CSL and GRSE, each of them will be constructing 8 anti-submarine corvettes. As per the latest update, in the month of December 2021, CSL has started a steel cutting of 4th and 5th ship, and GRSE has laid keel for 5th anti-submarine warfare shallow water craft. In summary, both of these shipbuilders are at present constructing 5 anti-submarine corvettes each. Now, if we talk about the capabilities of these ships, its primary role will be to perform subsurface surveillance on coastal waters, coordinate anti-submarine operations with aircrafts such as P-8I and Romeo helicopters, destroy subsurface targets in inland waters and in mine-laying operations. In addition, the vessel shall have the capability to interdict and destroy subsurface targets in coastal waters. These ships can also perform search and rescue operations during both day and night in coastal areas, defend against intruding aircraft, and lay mines on the seabed. Like many modern fighter jets, which has a dedicated electronic warfare suite, this anti-submarine corvette has an anti-submarine warfare combat suite. The vessel features a hull-mounted and low-frequency variable depth sonar for detection of submarines. Besides, the vessel also has a fire control system, integrated platform management system, automatic power management system, and battle damage control systems. The vessel will be armed with torpedoes, rockets, and two 12.7mm machine gun in remote weapon station. The corvette will have a maximum speed of 25 knots and a range of 1800 nautical miles at a speed of 40 knots.
This was today's update. Please let us know what is your views about these in comment section. Feel free to post your comments and suggestions about any topic related to defense sector on which you want to hear from us. With this, I would like to say goodbye and Jai Hind, friends. Please like and subscribe our video if you have not done already. We'll be soon back with more interesting and amazing development happening in defense sector.